proclaim Jesus. Commit anew to God's way of justice, peace, right relations, love, towards and with and for all creation. In honor of the land, let us take a moment of silence and offer our gratitude. Amen. Well, good morning. This is it for 2023. I'm Sue Cap. I'm the minister here at St. John's United Church, Georgetown and Glen Williams. Welcome. It is hard to believe here we are again. Some of us will make it to midnight, many of us won't. A lot of us don't care, and it's okay. And so Christmas has come, Christmas is gone. Christ has come and will continue to come here in us, with us, in all peoples and all creation. And so I now invite our candle lighters to light our Christ candle this day.
When the designated time had come, God sent forth Christ, born of a woman, born under the law, to deliver from the law all who were subjected to it, so we might receive our status as adopted heirs.
The proof that you are children of God is the fact that God has sent forth into our hearts the spirit of the child who calls out, Abba. You are no longer slaves, but daughters and sons. And if you are daughters and sons, you are also heirs by God's design.
In People of Ceaseless Hope, Walter Bernard writes, we must be people of ceaseless hope. Every human act, every Christian act, is an act of hope. But that means we must be people of the present. We must live in this moment, really live it, not just endure it.
Because this very moment, for all its imperfection and frustration, because of its imperfection and frustration, is pregnant with all sorts of possibilities, is pregnant with the future, is pregnant with love, is pregnant with Christ.
On this New Year's Eve day, as 2023 ends and 2024 is set to begin, we give thanks for God's abundance in what was, and look forward to the morning star's promises of God's blessings in the new year.
Thank you.
based on Ecclesiastes 3. For everything there is a season,
and
a time to be born and a time to die.
Time
to break down and a time to build up.
A time to lead and a time to laugh.
A time to keep and a time to throw away.
A time to be silent and a time to speak.
A time to love and a time to hate.
A time for war and a time for peace.
God has made everything suitable for its time. God has done this so that all should stand in awe before God.
Whatever God does, endures forever.
So let us rise as we are able and sing together some verses about angels from the realms of glory. Opportunities that we might be blessed and your kingdom comes in and through us. As we head into 2024, there are challenges and uncertainty. There is fear and anger and apathy and anxiety, so many mixed emotions. If we head into 2024 with you, O God. So help us receive your grace, your presence with us, your presence in the other. Help us to see and hear and taste and smell and touch and feel you each day, assuring us that we are not alone. Help us, O God, to commit to you, to your way, to bear your light and your love, proclaiming you through our actions. So come, Spirit, come. Bless our worship. Bless our lives and our living this day and each day throughout the coming year. This we pray. Amen. And so I invite congregational life to share with us announcements.
Morning, I'm Lynn White, and our congregational care are doing, well, this is the last announcement, I guess, for congregational care to do for this year. The first one, Kathy Bird has asked me to let everyone be aware that the senior men's luncheon is on Thursday, January the 11th. And all of you bakers out there, and we know there's a lot of you, we need some apple pies. So please let Kathy or Katharine in the church office know whether or not you can provide a pie or two for the men's luncheon on January the 11th. The men's breakfast is on Thursday, January the 4th, so that's this coming week, 7:30 a.m. at Angels, and all men are welcome. And then the ladies' breakfast is January the 8th, also at Angels, but not until 8:30, and all ladies are invited and welcome. Also on Monday, January 8th, the annual report deadline for the annual general meeting, which will be held after church on Sunday, January 18th. All committee chairs are asked to submit their annual reports to the church office by Monday, January the 8th. The people of Hillcrest and St. Andrews will be visiting us here at St. John's for a combined service to celebrate the Week of Prayer for Christian Unity on Sunday, January 21st at 10 a.m. So please, everyone, we're a very welcoming church. We're a very welcoming congregation. Please make an effort, extra effort, to welcome our guests by introducing yourselves to everyone and ensuring that they are aware that there will be refreshments served in Celebration Hall after the service. Friday, January the 26th is the first event of the 2024 in Sanctuary Concert Hall, and that will be every other Friday concert. Tickets are available on Showcase. And as we leave 2023 and welcome in 2024, we are a faith community who welcomes all with open doors, open hearts, and open minds. Happy New Year.
We give thanks for two new ministries that will be starting on January 1st in Paul Mills in Georgetown. We give thanks for Reverend Kate Young, who is coming to St. Andrews as an interim minister for at least 6 months. And we also give thanks for the new ministry at Norval, Reverend Heather Power is coming, and she's currently serving, or just finished serving this Sunday, at Parkminster United Church in Waterloo. So we give thanks for the new ministries, the new ideas, the new presence amongst us. And it's all women clergy in Germantown. Of course. So as we give thanks for all of our offerings that have been given this week and throughout the Christmas season, I invite you to pray with me and let me offer a prayer of dedication of these gifts. As the new year beckons, we offer our gifts, O God, our monetary offerings, our lives, our work, our leadership, our talents, our time, our presence, our all. Wherever we are, however we worship, we dedicate ourselves to doing all we can to bring your kingdom near. May your kingdom come through each gift we offer. Amen. Well, this morning, the next portion of our worship is a series of readings and carols. And so we will be singing a couple of verses. We will remain seated. I think everybody's had enough activity the last few days. And we welcome just being. Being with God. Quietly absorbing God through the readings and the music. And so I invite Leslie McCollett to come forward as she joins with me in this part of the service. Inspiration to action and direct hope towards a new reality. that can be shared by everyone in the end. The prophets of old offered the people hope. Who are the prophets of our time who offer us hope? Can we see them? Can we listen for their voices? Can we see the holy vision they share? Will we recognize it? Seek it out. Lean into the hope.
Thank you.
In violent times, beautiful words, centuries old, resonate with truth. Because of your light, God, we see the light. That light even now illuminating our terror-stricken age with the possibility of change, offering our overburdened hearts a resting place, that a deeper compassion may be our companion, an energy of love, to struggle for justice, to be a wounded healer, to share what we have, to carry hope in our hearts, to laugh and to love, perhaps all in one day.
Thank you.
darkness step by step against the invisible wind that blows forever around the world, carrying a candle is an act of foolhardy hope. Surely it will be blown out if the wind is contemptuous. The darkness cannot comprehend it. How much light can this little flame shed on all the great issues of the day? It is as helpless as a newborn child. Look now. Look how the human hand that cradles it has become translucent, fragile and beautiful, foolish and loving, step by step. The wind is stronger than this hand, and the darkness infinite. Around this tiny here-now flame that wavers, but burns, keeps burning, carried with such care through an uncaring world, from one little piece of shelter to another, an act of love. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never put it out. Acknowledging the past. In our hopes and dreams for the coming year, O God, you call us to rejoice, for your coming in flesh is indeed good news. Your coming as a baby in human form calls us to be childlike in our faith, always questioning, seeking, delighting in you and in the wonders of creation. You call us to rejoice in your promises fulfilled, in the new ministry starting in Georgetown, in Kate and Heather's presence, with the people of St. Andrews and Hillcrest and Morville and Trinity Acton. You call us to rejoice, and it's an invitation to dream dreams, seek your vision, to do more, to do better, to live your love with passion and compassion. In our hopes and dreams for the new year, O God, you call us to renewal, to not be complacent or apathetic, so set in our ways, to seek out new ideas, new attitudes, new opportunities, new ways of being, to see you and seek you in one another, each other, every other, and through each other's worldviews and experiences. You call us to renewal. This call invites us to celebrate and wonder, to listen and learn, and ponder your wisdom from new sources, new people, new ideas, new hymns, new language, expanding our understanding of your vastness, your amazing, inclusive, and loving presence, made known to us in and through Jesus, who invites us to reflect so we may be changed, to rejoice that we may always be thankful, to renewed that we might bear his light and his love always, and bring God's kingdom in this place, in this community, together, as we share Jesus' prayer, saying, Great Spirit, our Creator, who is in all places, sacred is your name. May your wisdom guide us, your will be done in our lives as it is throughout creation. Provide for us today the nourishment we need, and forgive us our wrongs as we forgive those who have wronged us. Lead us on the path of understanding and respect, and protect us from ignorance and harm. For you are the source of all power, beauty, and love, from generation. Let us go to be light, to share light. We proclaim light. And so I invite you to join with me responsibly in our commissioning and blessing. Let us look for Jesus wherever we go. Or believing there is a light that shines in the darkness.
Which the darkness cannot overcome.
And may the love of